Good morning, children. How are you all doing? I hope that you people are all doing very safe at home. So, welcome back to our English class. I'm so happy to see you all. I hope that you people are also very much excited about the English class. So, today what will we be learning? So, today we will be seeing some textbook exercises. But before that, let us have a small recap about the previous recorded class. So the previous recorded class was completely based on a story. So I had recited a story to you, and the story is called as Simon Says, and the story completely revolves around four main characters in the story, that is Simon, which is a German Shepherd trained dog. Then we have a grandfather, we have Rita and Rita's mother. So here the story is completely based on these four characters. I request the children to please do listen to the story at least once or twice, so that you will perfectly understand what is the story exactly about. So without any further delay, so sorry, I'm trembling a lot today. So without any further delay, let us get back into the exercise. So I want you people to open up page number 26 in your textbook. So before we start doing the textbook exercises, please do get your pencils, your erasers ready, and let us go into the exercise. So as I told you, open up page number 26. So we have the vocabulary part, that is the grammar part of the textbook, is what we will be learning today, and we will complete this chapter today itself. So this is meaning in the context. So what you are supposed to do in this exercise, let me read the question first. Read these sentences from the story, identify and circle the correct meaning of the highlighted words. If you are not sure, find the sentence in the story and read it. First tell me, what is a highlighted word? If you are not sure, let me tell you that. So the highlighted words, let me show you that. Okay, so if you take out your textbook and if you see the sentence over here, all the sentence over here is normally written, but one word over here is highlighted, it is darkened. So this is the highlighted word for which you will be finding out the meaning. Already they have given you three optional words, so you are supposed to tell me which is the correct word, that is the correct meaning of the highlighted word. So no more delay, let us get into the exercise. Okay, I keep telling you this very repeatedly, you know. That's the way I talk. Okay, so let's get back to the exercise. The first one, Ma had brought Simon back to our place, but he just moped around the house. The word moped is what you are supposed to find out the meaning. They are given you three options. The first one is sniffed, second one sulked, the third one is walked. So sniffed, we all know that dogs usually sniffs means smells. It smells, okay, so sniffs. The second one is sulked. Sulked is a new word to you. So the meaning of sulked is disappointed. I want you to write it right now as I have also written. So the word sulked means disappointed. Then third option is walked. So what is the meaning of moved over here? Let me read the sentences once again. Ma had bought Simon back to our place, but he just moved around the house. So was he sniffing or was he just walking around? No, he was very disappointed. So I want you people to circle the word sulked. Sulked means disappointed. So Simon was disappointed. The second one, before we go to that, excuse me about the dogs which are barking outside. Seriously, I'm not able to do anything about it. I don't know, they keep barking and just barking. So sorry about that. Okay, so let us get back to the exercise over here. The second question, then grandpa told me how much he longed to be home, how he hated being in the hospital. So they have highlighted the word longed. If you can see over here, they have highlighted the word longed over here. So what is the meaning of longed is what you're going to tell me. First option, thought about. Second, imagined. Third one, really wanted. So what did grandpa want? He was thinking about it, or did he imagine about it, or he really wanted to go back home? So the answer is he really wanted to go back. So longed means really wanted. So he really wanted to be home. So I wanted to circle really wanted. That is the meaning of longed. Third one, he must feel like I've deserted him. Deserted. So the highlighted word is deserted. So what is the optional answers they have given you? They have given you options like left, blamed, sold. So what did the dog must have thought? That is what grandpa was imagining, that the dog must have thought that I have sold him or blame him. No, grandpa thought that Simon would be imagining that grandpa has deserted him, meaning left him. So he left him. So I want you to circle the word left. Okay, the fourth one, for the fourth one, it took Ma 2 weeks to convince the doctors to let grandpa come home with us. So they have given you again three optional answers, I mean options of answers over here. First one, make a suggestion. Second one, offer help. Third one, make someone to do something. So what did here Ma ask the doctors? She convinced. Convinced means she was asking someone to do something. So she was asking the doctors to let grandfather from the hospital. That means she wanted grandpa to be discharged, because that is what even grandpa also wanted. He did not like staying in the hospital, right? So the word convince means make someone do something. So let me show you the last one. Make someone do something is the meaning of convince. The fifth one, both made a slow and steady recovery. The first answer, return to normal state. Second one, find something new. Third one, carry heavy things. Recovery means return back to normal state. So the first option is the right option. The first one is the right option. So these are the highlighted words for which you found out the meaning. The next part of the grammar we will find out. We will be learning about kinds of sentences. Okay. So in a sentence, we have four types of sentences. Normally, kinds of sentences, we have four types of sentences. So let me show you. I have written it over here on the board. The first one is statement. So this, we are learning kinds of sentences. The first one is statement, second one is a question, third one is an exclamatory, fourth one is an imperative. So we have four kinds of sentences. So let us see what are each one. Okay, let me tell you what is each one. So first one, I told you statement. So what is a statement? Usually which gives information is called as a statement. So any sentence which gives information is called as a statement. So I have given you an example over here. Grandpa is my favorite person. So it's a statement, just a normal sentence. It has given me an information about grandpa. So grandpa is my favorite person. So usually in a statement, it usually ends with a full stop. Any statement which usually ends with a full stop, remember. So what is a statement? Statement is nothing but any sentence which gives information is called as a statement, and usually it ends with a full stop. I've given you a very beautiful example over here. Grandpa is my favorite person. The second kind of a sentence is question. Question, usually when we ask for information, when we usually ask for information is called as a question. And usually any sentence which ends with a question mark is usually a question kind of a sentence. Okay, based on a question type of a sentence. So here I have given you an example. How is Simon? I am asking an information about the dog Simon, and usually my sentence ends with a question mark. So what is a question? Usually asks for an information. What is a statement? Which usually gives information. Question usually asks for information. The third kind of sentences is exclamatory. Exclamatory, usually it ends with this kind of a symbol, okay? Usually it has a down kind of a line with a dot. This is an exclamatory mark. And what is an exclamatory? Which shows strong feelings or emotions. Usually it shows strong feelings. For example, Imagine your class won a match, a cricket match, okay? So what would you people express it as? You're very happy and you all shout, hooray, hooray, we won the match. The word hooray actually ends with an exclamatory mark. If I say hooray, hooray ends with an exclamatory because it shows a strong feeling that you're very happy, okay? So what is a exclamatory? It shows strong feelings or emotions. Strong feelings, it can be disgust. It can be joy, sorrow, anger, excitement. Excitement words like wow. If you say wow, that's a beautiful painting. Wow, that's a beautiful dress. And suppose if you drop something down and it broke into pieces, you're like, oh my God, I broke it. That also will come under exclamatory. And disgust, if you see something very dirty on the floor, you feel it's very disgusting, you say, she's spitting on the floor. So that is disgusting. So usually which the sentence which shows strong feeling or emotions is called and also ends with this kind of a mark is called as an exclamatory sentence. The last one, imperative. But in your textbook they are not given the word imperative, but actually in kinds of sentence this is the last one which is called as an imperative. And under imperative we have two types, which is a command and the request. A sentence which will be like a command and a sentence which ends with a request. For example, let me give you an example for a command. If I tell you stand up on the bench right now, it is a command from the teacher asking you to stand up on a bench. So that is a commanding sentence. And request, we usually add pleasing words like please, will you get me a glass of water. You're requesting but you're not commanding over here. So in this imperative kind of sentences, usually they also end up with a full stop only. It depends on whether it is a command or whether it is a request. So that we have to find out whether if they are requesting us or they are commanding us. So I will repeat to you once again, in kinds of sentences there are four types. First one is a statement. Statement usually gives information and ends with a full stop. Usually it ends with a full stop. Just remember that. Question, which asks for information and ends with a question mark. Exclamatory shows strong feelings and emotions. Usually ends with an exclamatory mark. This is an exclamatory mark. Okay, just have a look. Imperative, it is of two types. We have two kinds of sentences into imperative, which can be a command where I order you to do something. The second one is a request where I please someone to make them do something for me, that I request them to do something for me. Okay, so these are the kinds of sentences. So let us go into the exercise which is there in page number 27. This exercise is actually based on your regular routine of life. Okay, but right now we are not going into a regular routine of life, like you people coming to school, we learning things in the school and you getting back to the house. It is not that regular routine. It is completely changed that you people are always there in the house and I'm there on the other end of my house and we are learning through the internet basis. So here, let us imagine that we are into a regular basis of school going and I have written certain sentences which happens in our regular life. So here, what are they asking us to do? Think about sentences people said to you yesterday. So you have to imagine the words or whatever dialogues were spoken to you yesterday. But it can be by your parent, yeah, like your father or your mother, your brother, sisters, anybody, your friend you met over a phone conversation. So whatever it is, that is what they are asking you to do. So think about sentences people said to you yesterday. Were they statements? So you should tell me, was it a statement they asked you to do, or was it a question they asked you to give an answer for? Was it an exclamatory that you met a surprising ones, or something disgusting, or you were very sorrowful or in anger? And was it a command or a request? Write two examples for each. So they are given you characters and you are supposed to write their two usual dialogues that they usually tell to you. So the first one, mom. So the first one is mom. So mom, what she usually tells to you, okay, what your mama usually tells to you. So I have written these sentences based on what I have heard in my childhood days. Okay, so first one, my mom. Okay, my mom, she usually asks me, did you wash your hands before eating? That is a question. She usually asks me a question, did you wash your hands? And most of the time she tells me that I'm so proud of you, which is an exclamatory one. It ends with an exclamatory. She's so proud of me. Okay, so that is an exclamatory with all expression. She's so happy. So exclamatory, I told you, show strong feeling. So this is happiness, that is joy that she shares. She says that I'm so proud of you, which is an exclamatory sentence. My father usually tells me, finish all the vegetables on your plate. He commands me, usually he commands me, telling that, finish all the vegetables on your plate. And the next one is, one sec. So usually my dad commands me, saying that, finish all your vegetables on the plate. So that's a command. The next sentence which my dad usually tells me, okay, it's a good idea to sleep early on weekdays. So that's a statement he usually tells me, that's better to sleep early on the weekday. So I've written statement, one sentence is my dad usually tells me. Then my teacher usually teacher tells stop talking. Okay, it's an exclamatory. Okay, she's commanding you to stop talking. Next one, always revise your work before submission. It's a statement. Always revise your work before submission. It's a statement. Your friends, your brother or your sister. So usually my friend, she says, please help me with my homework, which is a request because she's pleasing me. So it's a request. And the next one is, you have scored the highest marks in English. So that is an exclamatory. So I hope that you people have understood this. Now, why it is an exclamatory, you must be wondering. Why ma'am has put exclamatory? Looks like a statement, because you are surprised that you have got the highest mark in English. Imagine that you have got fully 100 out of 100. You think you'll come in normally, I've got the highest mark in English. No, you'll be like, I have got the highest mark in English. So that is an exclamatory, which shows your strong emotions. So these are the kinds of sentences, and I have written the answers based on my routine. That was when I was of your age, the routine basis of what my mom is to tell me, what my dad is to talk to me, what my teacher is to tell me usually, and what my friends, my brothers or my sister they is to talk to me. Okay, that is what I have written. I think you people also can write the same thing. I will take a picture of it and post it on the WhatsApp group for you people. Okay, so next one is the listening part, which we usually skip this. So I have written a small word like skip over here. I hope you people also can write that. Okay, so the next one, what we are going to do is the punctuation part in page number 28. There is speaking part also. I think we will do the speaking part of the exercise in our online class, which we have it on Tuesday. So we will do the speaking part then. So right now we will do the punctuation part. So usually we know that we are supposed to capitalize the letter after there is a full stop. Whenever there is a full stop, the next letter, the next word, the letter has to be started with a capital letter. We know that very well. We have been learning it from our childhood. And also name of a person or name of a place, that also should be started with a capital letter. So please do remember this very importantly. So I have done this punctuation part. So I have written like Atul. It's a small story. I hope that you people all know that there are two very good friends. When they were going through the forest, suddenly a bear comes in front of them. So then the two friends, the so-called best friends, what happens is the other one actually doesn't even think about that the person is a friend, the girl or the boy is a friend. He just leaves her there and the other person just climbs up the tree and he goes to the top. He doesn't even rescue, he doesn't even bother about his best friend. So the best friend is completely shocked and he doesn't know what to do, because his best friend has already got up the tree and he's all alone standing in front of the bear. So immediately what he does, he faints and he falls down, holds his breath. It is believed that the bear doesn't eat dead animals. Okay, the bear doesn't eat dead animals. The bear usually attacks its prey. First he attacks his prey and only then he eats his food. So here what the clever friend does, he falls down, he faints down and holds up breath. The bear comes, sniffs the person and he thinks that this person is dead. and the other one has already climbed the tree and the bear just goes away. So the person who got up the tree, he gets down and he wakes up the person. He says that, hey, the bear has gone. Now just tell me, what did the bear tell to you? So that is actually the story that we have already here, already heard. And that is what they have given you. That story is supposed to punctuate. And let us see where we are supposed to do the punctuation part. So as I told you, the name of the person has to be capitalized. The first letter should be capitalized. Atul and Deepa. So they have written it in small letters. And you are supposed to capitalize this. And let me take a photo of this and send you. I have put exactly like where we are supposed to stop the sentences. They have not even stopped. They have not even given you a full stop. So let me take a picture of this and post to you on WhatsApp group. The next part of the exercise is the letter writing. So letter writing, this kind of a letter is called as an informal letter. So just give me 2 seconds. Let me erase the board so that I will tell you what is a formal letter and an informal letter. Because in letter writing, we have 2 kinds of letter, which is a formal letter and an informal letter. You people will be learning only an informal letter for now. I think in the grade 5 is when you will be learning how to write a formal letter. So we have a format to write an informal letter. So let me tell you, before that, let me clean up the board. Give me just 2 minutes and I will do just like this. Yeah, so I was telling you about letter writing. So I told you that letter writing are of 2 types. One is a formal letter, the second one is an informal letter. So what is a formal letter and informal letter? I'll tell you. Okay, so formal letter is something that you are writing to someone of your higher authority. For example, since you are very small children, you're in grade 3, your higher authority would be us, we teachers. Okay, so you people write a formal letter to us, like a leave letter. So a leave letter is called as a formal letter. When you are requesting for a leave and all that stuff, you write a formal letter. Okay, so but what is an informal letter? Sorry for the break. So an informal letter is something that, a letter which you write for your friend, your family members, all those letters are called as an informal letter. So a formal letter means which you write to your higher authority, like your class teacher or principal ma'am or MD ma'am. So all the letters which you write to the higher authority people is called as a formal letter. An informal letter is those letters which you write to your friends and family. And you people are only going to learn only an informal letter. You're not going to even think about an formal letter. So an informal letter has some criteria. You are supposed to write with certain rules. Okay, you just can't take a paper and start writing a letter to your friend. So usually we have certain rules about how we are supposed to write an informal letter. Informal letter. So informal letter. So how do we start writing an informal letter? So imagine that this is my white paper. I have taken my white paper and I am supposed to write a letter to my friend. So how we are supposed to write? Usually whenever we write an informal letter, we are supposed to imagine that there is a line over here and you will follow this line. This line, this imaginary line is what I am going to follow. I'm not going to start writing my letter here, or I'm not going to start anywhere according to my wish. We have a rule about starting the letter from the left hand side of your paper. Now I told you that imagine that this is my paper. Okay, so always you have to start writing. Everything has to come towards my left hand side, but nothing towards my right hand side or in the middle of the paper. Usually start from the left hand side only. So how do you start writing an informal letter? Usually you're supposed to start writing the letter with an address. Whose address? To the person you're writing the letter to, or your address? Okay, usually remember, the address what you are going to write inside the paper will be your address. Because on the cover you will write your friend's address, inside the cover, that is on the letter, you will write your address. Okay, remember, you will not write your friend's address, you will write your address. Now, why do we write our address? Suppose we change our house, we move away from the place, and you are letting your friend know that you stay in this place. That is why we write our address. Okay, so on the cover we write our friend's address, inside the letter we write our address, and usually the address has to be max to max of 3 lines, nothing more than that. So let me start out with, I put this symbol saying that this is number 25, 7th cross. Okay, Akash Nagar. Okay, I'll write Akshay Nagar. Akshay Nagar, Bangalore 16. Bangalore 16. So max to max, I wrote my address of only 3 lines, nothing more than that. So in a paper, you write 3 lines of your address. Then you leave 1 line gap. 1 line gap has to be left over here. Below that, you're supposed to write date, the date when you are writing the letter. So I'm writing the letter on 31st of August. So the format of writing the letter will be 31st August 2020. It should be full. Don't write the date like this, 31-8-2020. If you write the letter like this, it is wrong. You're supposed to write it in this format, 31 August 2020. See, I'm maintaining my imaginary line. Okay, I've not gone away from my line. I'm maintaining the line towards my left hand side only. So the first I write my address. So I write my address. Then I write the date. Date. Then I leave 1 more line gap and address my friend. I write my friend dear Shirley. So I write my letter to my friend dear Shirley. So I start writing my letter saying that how are you, how is your family, how is everything going on. I write all the things whatever I'm supposed to ask my friend. So imagine that I'm supposed to ask her about her days, how she's spending in Corona. I will be asking her, how is your life going on? Are you being very safe about yourself? How is the situation around your area? In my area, it is so bad, and my parents are not letting me go outside. I'm missing my school friends. I'm missing going to school. So all that, I write my letter to my friend. Now, after writing the letter, you're supposed to end the letter. Now, how are you supposed to end? With something called as some beautiful words. Okay. So I end my letter with loads of love. Loads of love, and I sign it with my name. You are not supposed to put a signature, but you're supposed to write your name. So I have written loads of love, Padma. So this is the way you're supposed to write an informal letter. Now, why do we write an informal letter? Usually we write an informal letter to our friends and family. So based on the question, we are supposed to write the letter. So we have a format to write the letter. First, we start on with the address. Address should be maximum of 3 lines, and address should be your address, not your friend's address. It should be your address. So max to max, you are supposed to write of 3 lines. That is what I have written. Don't write address, then write this. Just write your address. Nothing else you're supposed to write. Okay, this I have written so that I want you people to understand that you are supposed to write your address. Okay, so don't write the word address over here. Directly write the address. So I have written my address of maximum of 3 lines. Immediately you leave 1 line gap, and after that you're supposed to write the date. Date has to be written in this format. If you write it in this format, it is absolutely wrong. You're supposed to write it like I have elaborated and have written. I've written 31st August, because 31st August is when I'm writing the letter. So it is 31st August 2020. I've written 1 line gap. Dear, your friend's name. Dear Shirley is my friend. I've written a letter to her. So this is the body of the letter they say. Okay. So whatever you write, the content inside the letter is called as the body of the letter. So the body of the letter is based on the topic what we ask you to write. Okay, body of the letter. So this is called the body of the letter. Whatever you want to write
based on the question. So it depends on what I ask you. So I might even ask you, share the summer vacation that you spent last year. So you can tell about your summer vacation if you remember, what and all you did in the summer vacation, you can write. So if I ask you, share the experience that you're locked down inside the house by not meeting your friends, how do you feel? Express all that in one small letter. If I ask you that question also, you people can write. So that expression, whatever thought you have that you're putting it on the paper, is called the body of the letter. After writing whatever we have asked you, you have to leave one line gap and end it with loads of love, or your loving friend, your best friend, whatever you want to write. And the last will be your name. I hope that you people have understood the format of writing the letter. So let us meet in our online class. So online classes, again I will be telling you how you are supposed to write a letter. Again I will tell you the format. So any doubts that you people want to clear in the online class, you can shoot out your question as my usual dialogue. I hope you people have understood my online recorded class. So let us meet in the online class, children. Till then, chalo. Bye. Take care, children. Bye.